Hi guys, I am doing my theme Thursday. March 9th. I don't even know what day is today. March 9th. I don't even know what day am I on today. Anyways, theme Thursday this week is either animal prints or safari type animals, jungle animals, for boys if you don't, since they mostly don't have like leopardish prints. I'm gonna put this sleeper on Ryan. It is a Carter's newborn and it's got a little zebra on it. It's got three little bows and then it's a zebra print. This is kind of the only print, animal print item I could find that I have. I thought I'd give Ryan a little love since she's been a little bit neglected the last, going on almost 2 weeks with the new babies arriving here that belong to my dear friend. We also made a discovery the other night. Cynthia was missing, that we know of, she was missing three neonates. There's actually four total missing. One of them we know sold on eBay before we found her babies. And the other three, we weren't really sure what happened to them. And so we, I had asked her cousin about them, and her cousin had made the comment that her mom had sold a few of her babies to friends of hers that lived in their apartment building, because they lived in the same apartment building after the fire. I believe her mom moved into her building. I know her mom lived in a rental above a lady's house. Crystal found what it was. She lived in a rental kind of studio apartment above this lady's garage, and Cynthia put storage in, and there was a fire in the landlady's kitchen that spread to the walkway. I don't think it fully got to the garage. If it did, it got just a little bit in the garage. And I know the babies that I have, I can't smell smoke. And if you saw him, there's Teffy's butt. If you saw Crystal's video, she said that her friends to be made baby that she got that was Cynthia's has kind of a hint of smoke, but she was a cloth body. So I don't think they were able to clean her the same way they clean the vinyl dolls. But anyways, we weren't sure if the missing babies either were ones that couldn't be fixed after the fire or if they got sold to her neighbors. Well, I had been thinking about it. I have this neonate that mysteriously showed up at my house when my daughter was about 2-ish years old. Let's see if this fits Ryan's mouth. This doll kind of mysteriously showed up. It didn't have a return address on it. It was shipped from Indiana. It was addressed to my daughter. And all that was in it was a note that said, it was something along the lines like from an auntie in the baby think it over neonates group. Or from someone in the neonates group. The neonate and baby think it over group. It was something along those lines. And it was kind of a mysterious package. And I didn't really think a whole lot about it. There's really not much I could do. It's not like I could really send it back. I wasn't sure who it came from. I personally don't know of anybody in the neonate baby think it over group that would have an African alight baby girl neonate, weighted neonate. So, it was just this mysterious package showed up, and, oh, there's a little curl in her hair I'm trying to get out. So, didn't really think a whole lot about it until now. I didn't really have, like, my friend Tammy, when I told her about it, she's like, well, do you think it was Cynthia's writing? And I go, well, this was like 3 or 4 years ago. Honestly, I didn't think much about it until now. And, like, when I brought it up to Crystal would have been, said, you know, that would have been right around the time she moved from Minnesota to Maine. And thinking about it, Indiana would have been on her way from Minnesota to Maine. She probably would have stopped in Indiana. And I know she had told me that they stopped overnight in a state. She didn't say which state, which probably should have kind of been a clue to me at that point. But she never said which state they stopped in. She looks so cute with this little bow. I don't know if you can see it. But yeah, she never said which state they stopped in. And so there was nobody in the group that lived in that state, and I really didn't think much about it. And all the doll came in, it was in just a plain brown box, and it just came in a onesie and a pamper. Well, a Pampers brand diaper. The neonates that I have received, and I believe Tammy said hers did as well, came in, one of mine came in a onesie, one of mine came in an outfit. Both of them just came in a Pampers brand diaper, not like any other diaper. And honestly, the outfit that was on Caitlin, there's a picture that Cynthia took in 2013 that Caitlin is wearing this outfit. So I have a feeling that she changed her in that outfit in 2013 and she got sick. Would have been 2014 and then passed away 2015. So basically the outfit that Caitlin is wearing, I think Cynthia changed her in 2013. But, you know, my two came in these, in one in an outfit, one in a onesie. Abby, as you've seen in the video, came in just a onesie, which ironically, in Tammy's box opening video of Isabel, she asked me, she's like, I got this weird extra outfit in mine. Did anybody get that? You know, it's got Piglet on it. And I'm looking at the outfit in the video and I go, Tammy, that outfit goes to the onesie that Abby's wearing, which is kind of funny because Abby is Tammy's. So I go, you have the complete outfit for that. And then Isabel, I can't remember if she came in a sleeper or what. And then I can't remember what Claire was listed to be wearing. But anyways, so you know, these babies arriving in like just random onesies and wearing just a plain Pampers diaper makes me wonder if Cynthia, as she was traveling from Minnesota to Maine, mailed off this doll to my daughter. And she didn't want to say anything about it, and she didn't put the return address because she knew A, I'd probably tell her no, and B, I couldn't send it back if I knew without a return address. But, you know, Cynthia really loved my kids. I know she really loved my kids, and she was actually one of the few people that had my address. She, when we had our initial meetup in 2007, my husband and I were living in an apartment. 2008, he deployed. 2009, he came home and we bought a house. When we bought that house, I think Crystal, Cynthia, and maybe two other friends, I don't even know if they knew it or not. I know Crystal and Cynthia had my address to my house. Crystal would periodically send things and gifts to my kids, and Cynthia would as well. Cynthia was kind of like big grandma, or not big grandma, like a grandma to them. And I had made the comment to her cousin about how my son has been attached to Caitlin. And I'm like, you know, they kind of had this bond, even though they never met each other, that I would talk to Cynthia on the phone and I'd put it on speaker. And my son, like, she would be talking to him, and being my son is on the spectrum, like, he really can't, at that point, couldn't have a back and forth conversation. So he would be talking about something, and she would talk back to him about it, and then he'd switch the subject. I mean, just, he would talk to her like he would talk to anybody on the phone. Although he didn't really talk to many people on the phone because he didn't want to, but she kept his interest. And there'd be times, like, he wasn't feeling well, and I'd get a text message or from her, is everything okay with your son? You know, I feel like he might not be feeling well. Is everything okay? Like, she was generally worried about him, and, like, she would ask this even before I said anything about him, even on Facebook or whatever, about him not being feeling well. And somehow she knew this. Like I said, the two of them had this connection. So then when he kind of, we got Caitlin, and he's kind of, oh my God, this is my doll. Like, he had, like, he wants to play with her. He wants to hold her. The other night, he wanted to bring her to bed with him. I mean, he's kind of attached himself to her doll. So I made the comment to her cousin about my son and his attachment to the doll. And I said, you know, he is 6, but he does have autism. And he responds back. He's like, oh my gosh. Cynthia used to talk, or he goes, I have a nephew with autism as well. And he goes, Cynthia used to talk a lot about your son. She goes, he said she loved that little boy with her whole heart. I mean, I'm bawling as I'm reading this, but I mean, that just shows what kind of bond the two of them had, even though they've never met in person. So, being I couldn't get Michaela, the electronic neonate native girl, even if she went to bed an electronic neonate, I love my absolute favorite mold that neonates and baby thinkovers were made, are the Native American mold. I absolutely adore that face. I just absolutely love that face. The reason why I wanted Michaela was because she was a Native American mold. I wanted Yukito because I didn't have any Japanese and I needed more boys in my collection. So I got him. And I'm in love with him. I love that face. But Tammy was actually going to get Caitlin until we realized Abby was a real care too. So Crystal and I both have a Caucasian real care 2 plus. So we decided Tammy... Well, not we decided. We told Tammy if she wanted Abby, that she could have Abby since she doesn't have any real cares. So Tammy was ecstatic about that, and then told me that I could, since we couldn't find Michaela, that if I wanted to get Caitlin. So I got Caitlin, and I mean, it's just how things worked out like that. And like I told Crystal, I go, it's almost like Cynthia wanted Caitlin to come here for Kobe, my son, and she had already sent prior, I can't even think of the name of the African-American girl. Starts with a K. But she sent it to Lainey, my daughter. Essentially both of my kids have a baby from Cynthia. So, I mean, it's really special, and I know I'm doing a changing video about Ryan and Ryan being neglected, and I'm talking about Cece's babies again. But, I mean, I'm just so... Do not chew on that hair. Taffy! But, yeah, I've just been in awe having these babies here. And like I had said, you know, they're going to be pretty regular in my videos, before they got here, I had talking about bringing, I had shown little clips with Luna, and I had talked about possibly packing her away, but, like, you know, this whole Cynthia bringing us back together has really re-sparked my love for my baby think-it-overs and neonates. I'm going to do another video coming up It'll probably end up being broken up, but I'm going to do changing videos of all my babies. I'm going to do changing videos of all my neonates and baby think-it-overs. And I honestly, I don't know if I'm going to pack them, do the changing videos and then pack them away, or put them all in the crib for a while. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with that, but unfortunately, if I do that, Rory probably will have to be put in my closet temporarily. But really, up till now, there was just a few changing videos with Rory. I mostly did stuff with Ryan, but you know, it's nice having other dolls that are finished to take out and do things with. So, and I'm getting back to, like, I want to enjoy them without, and not just have them sitting in the box. So I'm really considering doing that. So Rory might have to go in the closet for a little bit until I'm able to get him reborn. But that is it for this video. Ryan does look super cute in her little zebra sleeper. Let's see. Get a shot of her head. Or the shadow from Taffy. Taffy! Meow. Taffy. You, hey. You say hi. I don't know if you can hear her little noises. She makes those all the time. Right, boo. Oh, is that the spot? There is like one spot when you scratch this cat. You probably won't even be able to see it. She's just like a dog, and her back leg will come up if you hit this certain spot scratching her neck. Her leg will come up and she'll start doing like the thumping her back leg like a dog does. And now I have cat hair all over my hand. She's so neglected. Aren't you? Are you neglected? As you're rubbing me. But there is Miss Ryan, and I will see everybody later. Bye!